a simple way to apply machine learning is to use Orange. Let's have a look. There's a wide range of supervised learning algorithms. We looked at regression, we looked at linear regression when we have data that's related, and classification. We looked at logistic regression, support vector machines, k-nearest neighbor, and now we want to look at slightly different algorithms. Here we've got a decision tree, so we explain how that works. Many decision trees we can use in a random forest. Naive Bayes is based on probability, Bayes' theorem, and neural networks, we have input, and the result is the output, and in between is hidden layers. If there's more than one, we call it deep learning. So let's have a look at these classification supervised learning algorithms. Let's look at a decision tree. We're going to start off using a file that has weather data, weather.csv. So we're going to load that data. You can see here we've got the weather, cloudy, rainy, sunny, temperature, cool, hot, mild, humidity, high, normal, wind, strong, weak, and our target is, do we play? Yes or no? So that's our data. Now, we haven't got too much data. We can see this in the table. We can see we have play, yes and no, depending on the conditions of the weather. So we're going to use tree. We're going to connect our tree, and we want to see our decision tree. So we can use tree viewer to have a look at our decision tree. So we've got the default settings for tree, and we're going to connect that to a tree viewer. So let's have a look at our tree. So here we can see we have decisions, yes or no. So we have a look at the temperature. If the temperature is cool, yes, we're going to play. So in 2 out of 2 cases, 100%, if it's cool temperature, we will play. So you can see the yes is in the red and the blue for no. So if the temperature is hot or mild, we then check to see the weather. If it's raining, no, 4 out of 4 occasions. If it's cloudy or sunny, we look at the temperature. If it's mild, then yes. If it's hot, we then look at the weather again. If it's sunny, then no, 4 out of 4 times. If it's cloudy, then it's 50-50, yes or no. So we don't really know. So if the temperature is hot or mild, and the weather is cloudy or sunny, and the temperature is hot, and the weather is cloudy, then it's 50-50. But the other instances, we can tell if it's cool, yes. If it's rainy, no. And hot and mild. If it's hot and mild, cloudy or sunny and mild, yes. So our decision tree can be used to make decisions, although sometimes it's not clear. Now we can use this tree for predictions. So we're going to look for test and score. Connect our data and connect our decision tree, and we can add a table to see our results. Now when we see the results here, we can have our tree's predictions. We have yes and no, and we had the 50-50 when we're not sure. Perhaps a better way to see that would be using a confusion matrix. So we can connect the confusion matrix, and we can see we have the results. We have predicted an actual yes to play 5 times, no not to play 9 times correctly, and we have one prediction where we say no to play when it actually was yes. So that's our confusion matrix. Now, if you saw our video on confusion matrix, we also showed things like the metrics accuracy. So we have an accuracy of 0.93, precision, recall, quite high, F1 score. So 0.932 is quite high for F1. So the decision tree works quite well, although this set data set is actually quite small. We can see another example using data that comes with Orange by using the data sets. So we move the widget data sets, and then we want to use, actually we want to use the Titanic here. And now we can connect all of our widgets the same as before. So we can look at the data. Here we have the survivors, yes or no, the status, the age, and the gender. And we can get our tree. And let's look at the tree viewer as we did before. So if we look at our tree, this looks quite a bit bigger. So we can just adjust the zoom and the width here. Okay, so if we look at the gender first, we can see the survivors mainly from females rather than males. So if we look at the people that did survive, we're looking at males. We can look at age. So generally, the male adults didn't survive, whereas the female passengers mainly survived. And we can look in our tree, we have some that are in the third class that didn't survive, although the children, the boys, if they were in the first or second class, then they did survive. So generally, as a generalization, we could say that the males didn't survive the Titanic and the females did. So this is the decision tree. We can look at each step. We look at one decision, male or female, here, adult or child, the class, second or third class, or crew, first class, third class, second class. So we can go down each path in the tree to read our decision tree. If we want to look at our results, we can use test and score as we did before. We want to connect our data and the tree, and then we can look at the data. We can see there's quite a lot of data, so it's difficult to read, so perhaps best to use a confusion matrix. And if we connect that, we can see this is quite difficult. So where we've predicted survivors and not predicted not to survive, that's successful. But where we've predicted people not to survive, there's actually quite a few that did. So our tree is a bit pessimistic on the survival. So we can see in this confusion matrix that this is a bit of a more difficult problem to solve using a decision tree. And if we look in our test and score, we can see the accuracy is 0.791. So not as high as our first example. So the recall, trying to predict the people that survived, wasn't so good. So the accuracy, precision recall F1 score around like 75% to 80%. So not as high as our first example. But that's using the decision tree in Orange. Now we can use several decision trees together to make a random forest. So let's have a look for a data set using the Iris data set. And we're going to start off, let's have a look at the data. Here we have the different types of the iris plant. And then let's start off by creating the tree. and we're going to use test and score, and we're going to look at the results using a confusion matrix. So this is our decision tree we've used before. Let's connect the tree to the test and score. So here we've got the different types of the iris, and we've got some pretty good results in the decision tree. So most of the results are correct. So we have three errors in our results we can see in a confusion matrix. Now what we can do is we can use a random forest that uses several decision trees together, and then we'll look at all the results and then choose what it thinks the best results are. So here we're going to use 10 trees. But the point is, with our decision tree, we can merge different decision trees and pick out the best results from them in our random forest. And we should get, as you can see here, improved results. So the results can change depending on how the random forest chooses the decision trees. But you can see here, we've only got one error, and in our just one decision tree, we had three. So random forests, a way of using multiple decision trees. Now we have several classification supervised learning algorithms and different approaches. We saw the decision tree. Another way would be to use probability. So let's have a look at an example using naive Bayes. So we're going to use a data set on bank marketing. We can look at our table for our data, and we've got a lot of data here. So quite a lot. So we're looking at different features to, I assume, to get a loan. We have yes and no. So we want to use naive Bayes. So we can put in naive Bayes and connect that. And again, we're going to use our test and score. And again, we have our table. So we can see our results. Again, there's quite a lot of results, so it's difficult to see a general view. But can you notice, if we look at the percentages, we can see that naive Bayes gives a high percentage when we think it's yes, and a low percentage when it's no. And in the middle, when the percentage is around 0.5, we can see we have some errors. So we can see the overall results, perhaps with a confusion matrix is the best way. And if we connect that, we can see, yeah, we can see the results. It's quite difficult. So predicted yes and predicted no, we have a relatively good success. But quite a lot predicted yes when they were actually no. That's quite a high percentage. So if we look in our test and score, we can see the accuracy around 0.738. So precision, not too bad. Recall, quite low. F1 score, not great. So this is a difficult problem. But we can see we can use probability using naive Bayes to get these results. Now, quite a powerful machine learning tool is a neural network. So let's have a look to see if we can use a neural network for the same problem we use as naive Bayes. So we're going to connect our data set to another data table, and then we're going to use a neural network. So we can connect our data to the neural network. You could see this takes a bit more time for Orange to process it because it's a little bit more confusing and complicated. So we connect our data to the test and score. you can see again is going to have to take some time to calculate the results. And let's have a look to see if we can compare the confusion matrix. Right, so with our naive Bayes, our confusion matrix, we saw quite a few errors. So if we compare the naive Bayes, you can see here that your neural network has far greater success. So we can look in our test and score, and we have very high F1 score, like 99.9%, very good for the neural network. As the naive Bayes, just on probability, F1 score of 0.784. So in this case, in this instance, the neural network is very good at using the features to classify our model in a yes and no target. So that's the neural network, which we can also use inside Orange. If you think other people can benefit from watching this video, tell them or share it with them. If not, just click the like, subscribe, notification bell, and see you for the next video.